do a little Mad Lib with me. So, could you guys give me the name of an animal?
Kangaroo.
What about a verb ending in ing?
Sleeping.
A plural noun?
Shoes.
A past tense verb?
Swam.
A noun?
Clock.
And one more noun.
Case of pizza.
Awesome. Okay, so that makes our sentence. Once there was a kangaroo who was sleeping shoes. He swam up a clock to hide away in his quesadilla. Doesn't make a whole lot of sense, right? So this is what the sentence was supposed to be. Once there was a squirrel who was carrying nuts. He ran up a tree to hide them away in his house. So before we talk about that, I want to show you one more thing, and I want you to try to think of what they have in common. 119. The words, and you kind of know that that's going to say puddle because it rhymes with cuddle. So if we kind of ignore those two factors, what else do these two things have in common? What makes them both so funny?
They don't make any sense.
Exactly. That's exactly the next line. It makes no sense at all. And it doesn't make sense because it doesn't work with what we know. So this is part of making inferences. You make an inference with two skills. One, you use your background knowledge of the topic. So for the Mad Lib and the story, the squirrel story, you knew it, you could kind of guess that if you had all the words, that it would make sense that he was putting away nuts for home because we know that squirrels save food for winter. You also use what you logically know to be true. So it doesn't really make sense for a snowman to be in summer, which is kind of the joke of the song. And that's also kind of how you know that it's supposed to be a puddle. And so you have both of these skills that you're applying to these things. But you also need the text in order for it to make sense. So with the Mad Lib, you're adding in words, so it doesn't make sense until you have that. So with a squirrel carrying nuts, you can kind of assume from your background knowledge that it has something to do with winter, like I said before. However, if the story was about an alligator carrying nuts, it'd be a lot harder to make an inference about what's happening next, because I personally have no idea what an alligator would do with nuts. So that's kind of what an inference is. Now, that's a very baseline idea of it. If we're talking more about like why this matters in the big picture, especially in literature, let's look at this one storyline. Let's say we're reading a book, and there was a scene where a father becomes furious with his daughter for arriving home at 8:05 p.m., when she was supposed to arrive home at 8 p.m. The daughter tries to explain why she was late, but the father refuses to listen. He grounds her for a month. Does that feel fair?
No.
No, not at all. So that's a bit of an outrage scene. However, if we read a few chapters before that the father's husband and the daughter's dad had passed away from not returning one night, how do then you read that scene? What can you get from that scene?
Well, he was worried that she would also pass away because he had experience with his husband dying.
Perfect. So that's exactly what you can do with a larger inference. Now, I wrote up this little song to help you remember that based off of our good friend Olaf. I won't make you sing it because singing in a class is very uncomfortable, but if we could all say it together, that'd be great. One, two, three.
Thank you for the time to use knowledge and background, but put it in context and I'll be a happy student.
Great, thanks guys.